Manning must have used it to stop the bleeding from getting all over the place.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying that he was shot, he was bleeding, but somehow he managed to sneak out of here without a trace.
I know it sounds crazy, but that's what Manning is trying to do. Make you think that I'm loco.
It's working.
What? I mean, you just don't believe me?
No. No, I don't. Paul, look, you need some help. You need serious help.
I am not going to stand here and listen to my own flesh and blood call me a lunatic.
This is what I think might have happened. You hit your head when you were lost in the woods, and now it's having an effect on the way you're thinking.
Asa, you really should see a doctor.
I don't need a damn doctor.
Well, that's not open to discussion, because you're going to see one if I have to drag you all the way down there myself.
You. So, what are you going to do, police commissioner? Knock me out? Roll me up in a rug like that tramp Blair did?
Okay, Asa, you know what? Bo's just worried about you. We're all worried about you. You have been through a hell of a lot.
Yeah, you say you're fine. Then what's the big deal about seeing a doctor?
You're right. All right, I'll see you tomorrow. Right. Now, both of you, go. Beat it. Go, no, Dad. No. Get out of here.
No, sorry about that. I'm not going anywhere. You're not going anywhere either, if that's what you're thinking about.
Damn you, Manning.
Definitely something wrong.
Yeah. I guess we'll know more about it tomorrow after he sees the doctor.
Yeah. You know, it's late, so you don't have to stick around.
Are you sure you don't need me?
Yeah. Thanks for caring about Pa.
Call me.
I called you on the phone. Don't bring Matthew over yet.
I didn't. I came over here because I thought maybe you could use some help. Legal advice, anything at all. No? This has got to be hard on you, I know that.
Pa has been so out of it lately. I think we have to get him help, you know, before he does something that everybody's going to regret.
I assume that Asa sees this as ultimate betrayal.
What's the matter with you, Kevin? What happened to Kevin? Signed the papers and snuck out?
No, he has an appointment, and he's going to meet us at the hospital.
He's something. Tosses me in a pile of garbage. My own grandson.
Hey. Listen to me. I know how much you love having Matthew here. You know, coming for supper, for the night, making him Sundays on Saturdays, having him ride that beautiful pony you bought him. And he loves it. Loves it. But what if one time you're with him and you get so confused you don't know what's going on? What if Matthew winds up being hurt?
Nora, I'm fine.
And you probably are. You probably are. But Asa, I need to know that. And I want to know that when you're being obstinate and pig-headed, it's because you want to be, because you're Asa. So, just, please, just have the doctors look at you. I mean, what's a week anyway? Beau's gonna come visit you every day. I'm gonna bring Matthew every day.
You will?
Mm-hmm.
Nora, my being confused like this, is that bringing you and Beau back together? Because if it is, it's worth it.
Asa Buchanan, you are just as bad as Matthew. Hey, you know this. Beau is a wonderful, kind, caring man with a heart as big as Texas. Believe me, what he's doing today hurts him as much as it hurts you.
Well, the paramedics are here to take you to the hospital.
I won't need him, Beau. Tell him I'm going to go on my own. With you and Beau.
Hey, Daniel. I'm sorry that I couldn't reach you sooner.
That's okay. You ready for New York?
Well, actually, that's why I'm calling. There's been an emergency. Beau's had to commit Asa to the psych ward at the hospital, so he's not going to be able to babysit Matthew this weekend.
Oh, well, hey, what do you say I rent all the movies I can about New York City and we'll just hunker down for the evening, huh?
That is really, really sweet. But I'm sorry. I just can't go. I promised Asa that I would take Matthew to visit him, and then I think Matthew and I are going to spend the evening with Beau, you know, just to cheer him up.
Yeah, I see. You know, Nora, I was afraid you might get caught with Beau somewhere, but now I see you're planning it.
No, that's not fair. I don't think you understand.
Sure I do.
Hey, Kev called. Pa's calm. He's looking forward to a visit from Matthew, and Renee's on her way back from Texas.
Great.
Hey, look, I want to thank you for talking Pa into going down there. And I hope that it's not too late for you and Daniel to get to New York.
Oh, we're not going to go.
Why not?
Because I promised Asa that I would take Matthew to visit him. I didn't just promise him that I'd take Matthew. I promised him that the three of us would go.
Yeah, Paul understand.
Beau, I'm not doing this just for Asa. I know you. I know how hard this is for you. I know you're hurting.
Yeah, yeah, I am.
Okay. Well, so for me, I see hospital visits, lots of junk food, and a lot of video games with my two favorite guys.
That sounds good.
So, if you want to stop.
You think you got enough video games there, bud?
You got the whole night to play. Can I order a milkshake? Grandpa says they have the best milkshakes.
Go ahead. So, Asa seemed in pretty good spirits.
Yeah, I know. I expected him to be ranting and raving. And, you know, I don't know what you said that calmed him down, but thanks.
Oh, I think Matthew had a lot to do with that. You know, they have a very special relationship.
You know, Pa, he's tough as nails, and he's always bullheaded as he ever was. It's just, it's hard to imagine that he might have dementia or Alzheimer's.
We don't know anything yet.
You know, I checked every inch of his living room. Checked out that ravine out by the quarry. I called every hospital in four counties. He did not shoot Manny. You know, it's all just, it's a figment of his imagination.
Why is Grandpa in the hospital? Is he, like, gonna die?
No, sweetie, no. He's not sick like that. He's just, well, sometimes, you know, when people get old, they forget things.
Grandpa remembers everything.
Yeah, the important things, you know, like how much he loves you. But, see, we're just afraid that he might get lost or he'd forget to take his medicine. And, yeah, he's just in the hospital for a checkup.
Yeah. Don't worry, sweetie. He's going to be fine.
Are you guys going to forget me when your grandpa's age?
Oh, yeah, I love you too much.
And I'm going to go get the check. My treat.
Thank you.
That cashier's check there.
I'm on it, sir.
I'm sorry we couldn't go to New York.
Yeah, me too.
But as it turns out, Beau and Matthew have decided they want a guy's evening, and I'm XX baggage, so maybe...
Nora, I have to work late.
Are Mom and Mr. Coulson having a fight?
No, see, your mom likes Mr. Coulson very much. And if they weren't getting along, that'd make her very upset. So you don't want that to happen.
No, but I don't want her with Mr. Coulson either.
You know, Nora, I'm not very good at being the guy in waiting. Actually, I have a life of my own. I look forward to spending time with you, and more often than not, you get called away unexpectedly. You can't seem to make it. It's frustrating.
Are you jealous of Matthew?
Not Matthew.
Well, gee, I'm sorry. I've been quarantined with a deadly bug and locked in an elevator hanging by a thread and locked in a meat locker during an armed robbery. Gee, I'm sorry. I'm the one having all the fun,
aren't I? I'm not talking about all that.
Matthew's grandfather was just admitted into the hospital. He may be losing his mind. What would you like me to do?
I want you to figure out who you want to spend your time with.
Mr. Coulson! Vicky.
How about this one?
It's boring. I don't feel like playing any of these.
Don't feel like saving the world? You worried about your mom?
It's just she looked so sad when we left.
Yeah. You know, I've known your mom a long time. And sometimes when she's tired or if maybe she's feeling a little sad, she just likes to be by herself for a while. Tomorrow, you know, when she comes to pick you up, she's gonna be good as new.
Mom, you came.
Well, I figured if you guys are going to fight all the evildoers and save the universe, you might need a little help.
We can't decide which one to play.
Well, maybe this will help.
Oh, now you're talking.
Do you have any beer?
Oh, do I? Coming right up.
All right.
Come on, we can't save the world from aliens without you.
You say the nicest things.
Well, let's just say...
He is out like a light. I think he's been handling this ASAP.